Archaebacteria are eukaryotes. They reproduce asexually and can be found in harsh conditions such as thermal vents and geysers. They can survive these conditions because of their internal membranes. Archaebacteria are unicellular. Before the 20th century, scientists believed that all living things could be classified as plant or animal. Later, scientists discovered protists, bacteria, fungi, and most recently, archaebacteria. This was made its own kingdom separate from eubacteria because of its cell type. It has complex cells, while eubacteria have simple cells. Some examples are... Eubacteria are prokaryotes. They reproduce asexually and they are unicellular. They do not have a nucleus. They have their own kingdom because of their unique chemical makeup. They can be helpful or harmful. Harmful bacteria make toxins that the body must fight off, all while the bacteria is growing and dividing in the body. Helpful bacteria can help break down food and kill bad bacteria and fungus. Interesting fact, some bacteria can help clean up oil spills. Some examples are Streptococcus and Staph aureus. Protists are eukaryotic. They are unicellular and they reproduce mostly asexually or from binary fission, but sometimes meiosis occurs in protists. They usually live near water. They have a nucleus and membrane-bound organelles, and they have characteristics similar to plants, animals, and fungus. An amoeba is similar to an animal, algae is similar to plants, and slime mold is similar to fungus. They are different because they are less complex and do not have tissues and organs. Many organisms that do not classify as plant or animal or fungus that have a nucleus go into this category. Protists were probably the first eukaryotes. They are formed when a larger cell engulfs a smaller cell, and the smaller cell evolves into a nucleus. Some are able to move using flagella, cilia, and pseudopods. Some make their own food, and some absorb nutrients. Some examples are amoeba and slime mold. Plants are multicellular eukaryotic organisms. Their cells have cell walls that protect them and give them a rigid shape. They're autotrophs, which means they make their own food. They reproduce asexually or sexually. Plants are divided into two groups, angiosperms and gymnosperms. This kingdom includes all plants with more than 250,000 species. It is the second largest kingdom. About 360 million years ago, there began to be many varieties of plants. The most important characteristics of plants is their green color that comes from chlorophyll. It is used to convert sunlight into energy, or photosynthesis. Plants fuel the manufacturing of our food. Much of life on Earth would be impossible without plants, because they supply our food, shelter, clean air, and they regulate the temperature and weather. Some examples are pine trees and roses. Fungi are some of the most important organisms. They break down dead organic material, so they are an essential component to the cycle of nutrients. Plants could not grow without these nutrients in the soil. Fungi can supply medicine like penicillin. Some are edible like mushrooms and truffles. They can be harmful as well and cause fungal infections in plants and animals that are difficult to treat. Most fungi are multicellular and they have eukaryotic cells. Scientists used to believe that they were plants, but they cannot make their own food. They take in nutrients from dead organic material. They reproduce asexually or sexually. The animal kingdom is the largest and most complex. Animals have nervous systems, while many other organisms do not. They can sense and respond to their environment. They are multicellular and have eukaryotic cells. They reproduce sexually and have a unique offspring. A very wide range of organisms are in this kingdom. Mammals, insects, fish, birds, reptiles, and much more. There are over 1 million known species in the animal kingdom. Animals also have tissues and organs. Two-thirds of this kingdom are insects, and 97% of all animals on Earth are invertebrates. Invertebrates are animals that do not have a backbone. They are heterotrophs, which means they must feed on other organisms. Some examples are Sciuridae and Homo sapiens.
Thank you.